specially for preparing us a very nice lunch. I could see people were enjoying the food. Amen.
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 So thank you so much for that. By show of hand, I just want to recognize the people I came with from our church. Raise up your hands. Because time is gone, so I won't
do that again.
I am married, I have children. They send you greetings. As well as the church members. Okay. You can take your seats.
Wait till they call.
I pray God helps me. Because I'm privileged to be the first speaker. It's not easy. So I pray that I serve him and bless you too. The book of Acts, chapter 17, verse 10 and verse 11. The Bible says that the brothers immediately sent Paul and Silas away by night to Berea. And when they had arrived there into the Jewish synagogue, now these Jews were more noble than those in Thessalonica. They received the word with all eagerness, examining the scriptures daily to see if these things were so. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Father, we pray you bless your word.
Tata,
in Jesus' name, amen.
Yesu, amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The theme of our conference is overcoming doctrinal battles. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, when you look at this verse, Paul and Silas had been to different places preaching the gospel. But when he came to this particular place, they actually did not talk about Paul, but they talked about the people they found there. Amen?
Amen.
Which I think today is something that we need to look at critically. If we are to overcome some of the doctrinal battles that we have. The Bible explicitly says that these believers in Berea were more noble. The Jews there were more noble than those in Thessalonica. And there's something that made them different. Amen.
Amen.
Those in Thessalonica heard the word. And those in Berea also heard the word. So they all received the same thing. The word of God. They all had ears. They don't tell us that some of them were deaf. But they are giving us a difference between the two. They are telling us that these particular ones were different from the ones where Paul had gone from
Thessalonica.
And the Bible gives us the reason. It gives us two reasons. Number one, they received the gospel.
Amen.
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 Now listen.
What it is?
The Bible talks about the uniqueness of these Jews in Berea. It gives them this uniqueness. Number one, it says that for them, they were eager. Amen.
Amen.
Those in Thessalonica heard the word. But they don't talk about how they responded to it. Amen.
Amen.
They heard. And they went back home. But these ones heard. But the Bible tells us that they received it with eagerness. They set aside every other thing and focused to receive the word of God. They even decided, if it means giving in our time, we want to make sure that we don't miss a thing now that we've got these guys that have come to preach the gospel. Amen.
Amen.
And they showed a great eagerness. When someone is eager, they pay attention. So I think that because Luke is the one who wrote the book of Acts, I think Luke was looking at these guys and he saw them so eager. Amen.
Amen.
I think when he went to Thessalonica, he saw some as the gospel was going on. For them, they were busy saying, the pastor has no cabina. They were gospel.
Instead of kosho, I wish they cooked rice. Because you really feel it. Probably those of Thessalonica.
All
the time they spent with them.
There
are things they taught them in
school.
But they never yielded fruit. They taught them to pray. All the time they spent with them. Nobody could even pray for themselves.
They did not show eagerness.
Some of them were slumbering. Where the gospel was being preached. Others. Probably they say,
yes, Paul, you are bullied.
The Pope is preaching, we know him.
He
will tell us the usual things. They missed the essence because they took everything as common. But it was the same gospel. And it carried the same power. And the owner of it was
Christ.
Brethren, I want to tell you, when the gospel is preached, if you are not attentive to receive, it may not profit you. Even if we as long as there is none to
yawn,
like the people of Berea, desiring to know more than others, your life may not change.
twalina bangi betwali tuli nabo.
There are many people we were with.
Twayimbako mu
choir. We sang in the choir.
Miracle Center.
At Miracle Center.
Naye njagala okutegeeza.
But I want to tell you.
Twali mu
choir. As we were in the choir.
Naye nga waliwo ekintu kye tulaba.
There was something we were seeing.
Abalala baagala kuyimba buyimbi.
Others just wanted to
sing. Naye nga ffe twagala Mukama, ffe tuba tuyimba yabalabisibwa.
We desire that we receive God is not
manifested.
You remember?
Wabangawo n'omuwala nga bw'ayimba ne batamufuuwa.
There was another girl when she sang and she was not
praised.
She would leave the church.
Every time
she sang and was given money,
Ngajula.
She would sit in the service and complete it.
Yabanga zekola.
She was a worker. Money maker.
Doctrine.
Enzikiriza.
Doctrine yeno, ekigambo doctrine kitegeeza enjigiriza.
The word doctrine means a teaching.
Olukungaana luno lukwatagana ku njigiriza.
This meeting concerns the
doctrine. Omusumba gy'alyogerako.
What kind of doctrine is the pastor
speaking of? Si njigiriza ndala wabula enjigiriza ya Mukama waffe Yesu Kristo.
We are speaking of the doctrine of our Savior Jesus Christ.
Era ng'akkiriza.
And he believes.
Singa kanisa esigala ku njigiriza ya Mukama waffe Yesu Kristo.
The church can stick to the doctrine of Christ.
Bamusumba shaka bagenda kubeera bangi abagenda okuzaalibwa.
Many likes of Pastor Shaka will be born.
Bamusumba isiko bangi bagenda kuzaalibwa.
Many likes of Pastor Shaka. But I want to inform you.
Neyanziza nti onyambye n'okuba ku bugalo.
Thank you that you're
naye okuba engalo tekimala.
Clapping your hands is not enough.
Wategedde okubaawo omuntu aliko by'awandiika.
Somebody should be noting down.
Mbana ki wano? Katonda ayogera nange ki wano?
What am I living
in? Kiki ekiddako nga nfudde wano?
What next after here?
Ekyo Luka teyakiraba mu Thessalonica.
Luke never saw that in the people of Thessalonica.
Akati kambalabule.
Now let me warn you.
Musumba Shaka ye yatidde dda.
Pastor Shaka was a
era nalabye bunayinamu n'ebiwayo ebyaba 70 day baba katuliki byaba ki.
He has denominations.
Ne Luka bw'atyo bwe yalaba.
Bwe
baali e Thessalonica yalaba enneeyisa yaabwe.
N'atya. He was afraid.
Agamba omusajja n'aweereza ebintu buli ebikolera abalala.
He said, how can a man share stuff that works for others? One minister, when he preaches, the lamb walk. But there was a lamb person who was seated in front. All the rest walked. And this one rejoiced over the
breakfast.
But he himself never got out of the chair. And the preacher was
he wondered
why this one was not healed.
Yeah,
and laid the hands on the knees. He was only humbly looking at the preacher. He never got healed. Later, he asked him, I have struggled so that you can be healed. Why are you not healed? And this one told him, here in the chair where I'm sitting, if the feet are restored and I walk, you may not see me again.
N'agamba mu mirembe gy'ondabamu.
He said, the peace is
naona dda, neeraba naona
dda. I see myself here.
Naye n'okutya amagulu ge gaddamu.
But I'm afraid.
Ge nava manyiiyo.
I know where I go.
N'amagulu ge gaali manyiiyo. Osalira n'empona.
If I get healed,
bali abalala kabawone.
Let others be healed.
Nze nsigalemu akajja wano akavuga akagaali kange akajja okutuula wano.
But let my lameness keep drawing me to church. What stopped him from being healed? He believed. The condition he's in, it's enough.
omukristaayo omunenyeza abasumba
tibabuulira
bubi
tibabayigiriza
naye abakristaayo nammwe mulina
obuzibu
omulimu si gw'abasumba bokka
kubuulira
bano be boogerako bwe baawuliranga
bayibuli
egamba baalinanga okuyaayaana
Today you preach to a church that doesn't
disagree.
Someone is thinking of the girl they want to
propose.
The other is thinking of the next program. The other is thinking of the barbecue they are going to have. So the word is preached. And you can ask somebody that and they say, oh, the man preached. Now, how will you survive the trial of evil doctrines if you don't give
time?
If you don't invest
time
to pay attention to what is being taught,
what do eager
people do? Somebody can.
They
don't just clap their hands.
They
don't only say amen. But they even ask questions.
Pastor.
They even go back home and say, Pastor. I
didn't
understand. These things.
Bagambe.
Tell them. Preaching. There is what is there. And there is what is for others. So we are struggling with wrong
doctrines.
Some people have multiple pastors, some of which are not
religious.
If we are to survive wrong
doctrines,
we must force the believers to
hear
and involve themselves in desiring to know beyond the usual. Now that is not the responsibility
of
pastor. Pastor prepared. Your role is to do what?
Kuja.
Is to come.
Where is the transport?
Others are waiting for transport. If they don't send them transport, then the pastor will suffer with the meeting. That's how the people of the Thessalonica were. And Paul never impacted them. You can live with a
power.
But end up without tapping
As for example.
Who knows Judas
Iscariot?
Nobody had a powerful pastor like Judas Iscariot. But Judas failed. Judas never tapped into the power of Christ. He was on his own business, but he was at the source. It is possible for a believer to be
transformed,
where people are being transformed, but they themselves are transformed. ekibuuzo kyange oyagala kubeera basesalonika oba oyagala kubeera bano abebereya abaagasa abasesalonika tebagasa na kugasa abo abawulira obuwulizi nebaga musajja abuulidde ne baddayo waka tebagasa kubanga n'okuyiga tebayiga They get tired so easily. When a situation comes, they run away. Because they have nothing to restrain them from running away. Judah amazes me. Until now. Jesus said that the one you even give me an answer and I fail the test. Jesus said that the one I give some food, the one I give will be the one who had betrayed
me.
All the believers
said, what?
Judas was quiet in the church of Christ. Was the problem. Jesus' gospel of Judas had the problem. The knights of Judah, arise, learn for God, and he will work for you. Believers nowadays don't want to
pray,
but they want to be prayed for. Judas is seated. Jesus is working. Judas is working. He is less concerned. They said, the one I will give part of my food. When they gave you don't even pretend. Believers are not committed to
truth.
No matter how much truth is spoken in the way. What I'm saying, our yearning should surpass. If we are to experience the revival or renewal we are yearning for, ask your neighbor, have you ever asked your pastor some questions? Others ask for marriage treats.
Pastor,
if a woman for sure is sweating, the relevant questions are nowhere. If you don't read the Bible, what will challenge you to ask your pastor anyway? How many of you are grasping what I'm saying? Revival doesn't begin with pastors. Revival begins with the believers that are yearning to see God using them. If you don't have this, we can do several occasions
you,
but you will remain the same. Judah got the morsel of food. Can't you humble yourself?
You
see me. So they have given me the meal. He positioned himself to receive. Those are believers that are selfish. Ever complaining. The other place they gave soda, why aren't we getting anything?
same one working here. They are the ones who gauge and say there is no
Naye
baganya
okuwa omwaganya Katonda akole ku bulamu
bwabwe. In actual sense, they themselves have hindered God from working in their lives.
Amen.
The people of Thessalonica,
batunulira Pete,
they looked at Peter, Paul, and he preached to them. The scriptures said, the Jews of Berea had a difference. A believer that will see God at work, there must be certain qualities. There are certain qualities you should put into yourself. Number one,
eagerness.
You must have the eagerness. Amen. Don't you want more churches than those that were there before? Every few meters you will find a church. And churches mushroom every
Uganda.
There are churches that
every day,
and others mushroom every day. How can you sit?
No,
God is leading
the
church. And you just put it so close to your
feet.
These ones are praising. You are also praising on the second floor. Where did you learn from? The Lord also
is here.
And he has told me, I'm taking over all this territory. The people of Berea were different from they of Thessalonica. When they heard the word, they heard it very
well.
People who pay attention to the word raise their hands.
Paulo, chino chowayo gende sebotata. Choche chichi.
They seek clarity.
Paulo gabategeza.
And Paul would clarify to them. The other one and the last one.
Paul agamba.
Paul says,
these people
took a step
of examining the scriptures daily to see if these things were so.
Amen. After the preaching, they would say, my, it was a powerful preaching. It is not Paul who followed them up. He preached. Nowadays, believers
don't
sense who is right. They came at our church, introduced themselves as
believers. Special.
Later, I found him on the seventh day. I said, I see it.
Brother.
It is like finding you praising on a podium of
Muslims.
And they give you their rhythms. It is not enough to say fire. Many believers are like that. Others, they
supply demonic altars. sasambasisamidde lubaali
ankubemubito era
abasamize baga mulokole leero kyozze kukola
gamba
muno bonna tusaba nabo
ate
nga bonna bakristaayo nga ne pasita balanga nti kikonyogo muyina lubwama muyina katerega muyina suzana muyina nagwayo muyina nena muyina ne celestina muyina era kati waliwo neŋŋombe
And there is a saying.
Kebacha agambwako.
You cannot
talk
to them
about
it. When they ask them, I still come out of
your church.
Believer says,
Who assistant Jesus?
Are you assistant Jesus? Immune to correction.
Ani akuwa oruku sakuramu wangu.
Who gave you right over my life?
Where is
so they say.
I am the
one who died for me at
Calvary.
He died at
Gologosa.
So
they get the same
story. You won't shout, but they are more important. After listening like we have
heard,
when they close their Bibles, they wait for another day. That's
what
we struggle
to lift up
their hands. Throw all your arms in the air.
Amen.
If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
If we still have such a conduct, if we cannot examine anything, sometimes you just talk about somebody and the person threatens you and says if you go far I will stop being a member. Is it salvation about the clothing or the heart? To show that God changed you is the outward. You bear fruit.
Amen.
Oh, you are valuable. How did you know that I'm a vulgar? You are also vulgar. Self-defense. These people have two
characteristics.
If we can avoid
them,
if we can embrace them, it will be easy for our pastors. Our pastors will not develop gray hair before their time. Our pastors will trust us.
They were eager to receive. How is your eagerness to receive from God? How often do you give in your time to read His word? How often do you ask questions when you've not understood the word of God? The Jews in Berea had that uniqueness over those in Thessalonica. And that made them grow. It made them doctrinally healthy. Amen.
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 Secondly, they examined the word. Every single day. Olwaleero tulina n'owulira oli ng'agamba Bayibuli egamba lubaala embeera nga n'ebyomwotadde
sebaabalokolenebawanika
n'obutemu
nebakuba
n'enduulu kubanga agambye nti omusota gugenda leero
He has said, demon is ahead of me, as I also run for my life. The born against do not cross examine to see whether it is in the
Bible.
There are those who read the Bible for them. There are those who help them with that.
That is why it's wrong. When
man told me that Uganda
abantu baina okuyaya
people have a yearning but they lack roots in God. And when you ask them 2-3 questions in the Bible, they cannot respond back. Others to merely ask them why they got born again.
Sometimes
even ask them, why did you get born again? They will say, we used not to
be,
but now
we eat.
That's the reason why they got born again. The people of Berea, they had a uniqueness from those of Thessalonica. What made them unique was this.
Critical conclusion.
He said they were different.
They were quiet. But eager to receive. Anybody are receiving with eagerness, they allow the word to touch their lives and change their lives. Eager people grow in their walk with God.
Amen. A believer who has been there for long. 10 years. You give them a responsibility to lead the ushers. You give them a team of about 10 people. They return and say they all left. The good thing they did was to tell them, why are you struggling? That is the only thing they can do to encourage, they discourage. Even when they someone says, don't worry, they will ship in more from China. Don't worry, it is a call away.
Any sense of responsibility,
any
eagerness to serve, eagerness to learn, no question, no growth, no joy of the Lord, because they have never experienced it.
Experienced the joy of the Lord. One day a lady came to wash Jesus' feet.
We have this way.
A lady comes and
and Cliff.
Oh, and you get this or that.
Do you know what Judas said?
Yagama and
la veche on el derecho. What a waste, so he said.
Najukiza Yesu amubulirira.
And he began to counsel Jesus.
Don't you mind Uganda like you have?
Don't you know Uganda is full of poor people?
Yesu naga nomkazi oyo.
Jesus said this lady.
Do you see the eagerness?
Onamo kuyaya.
Omkazi yali eager.
The lady of the
Uganda na nyini pastor. I am one. Yet I have negatives.
But the one close to the pastor is only seeing negatives. When they say close your eyes, they step up with their eyes wide open. You are a monitoring spirit. He was among the first 11 of Jesus. Others were touched.
Mama.
But Judas. He was he said, we have to finish what we started. They gave him
food.
And the guy took the food. He ate. After eating, no pretense. He went to complete the mission. He went to
complete the mission.
He swallowed on his way to betray Jesus.
You see why we have doctrinal errors? And we blame our churches. How responsible are you to the church programs? How do you respond to the call when leaders call you to come and be part of a gathering like this? How do you respond?
This is funny.
Gamba Judah.
Judas.
Kumafuta ya gamba atya.
When they were putting oil on Jesus, he was seeing losses. Jesus told him, leave me alone. The time you've been with me, you've done nothing.
Yuda n'abatali bayigirizwa ba kumwanjo baawandiikibwa mu Bayibuli yali muna musango gwe gumu.